Hi, my name is Helen Talbert. I'm a park ranger here at Appomattox Courthouse National Historical Park, and this is the symbolic ending of the Civil War. For all practical purposes, this was where the war ended. It was the surrender of Lee's Army, the Army of Northern Virginia, here in the Mclean Home. General Lee got surrounded and outnumbered after he arrived in this area and agreed to meet with General Grant. And just by chance, the meeting was in the McLean's home, and this was just a private residence in 1865. Wilmer McLean and his family lived here. General Lee had sent his aide, Lieutenant Colonel Charles Marshall, into the village to find a suitable host for the meeting. Wilmer McLean happened to be the first civilian Marshall met, and he offered the use of his home to General Lee for the meeting. There was only one other building in the village that played a part in the surrender events, and that was the Clover Hill Tavern. When the generals met here, Grant said that the soldiers would have to surrender their weapons and agree not to fight anymore, and then they could go home as free men. But since Lee was just surrendering his army, he thought his men needed to be identified as surrendered soldiers and have protection as they were going home, and he asked that there be individual parole passes for them so that they could have something tangible to take with them, and they printed those passes in the Clover Hill Tavern building. Using portable army printing presses that were set up the next day on April the 10th. The meeting here was the afternoon of April the 9th, and then on the 10th they started printing the passes. It took several days to get those printed. They were issued to them after the weapons were surrendered, and they issued 28,231 paroles to the soldiers here at Appomattox.
The Appomattox Courthouse. Today you can walk around this historic building and other historic buildings in the village. Many of the buildings are open with Civil War displays inside. The museum has many displays and artifacts. Many of these artifacts were used during the surrender. A short distance from the village is a Confederate cemetery where 18 Confederates and one Union soldier found after the war are buried.